We begin this half hour with commitment 2010 coverage and big news in the race for the Democratic nomination for U.S. Senate. With the primary less than a week away, the latest News 8 Franklin Marshall College poll is out this morning, and it shows Joe Sestak now leading incumbent Arlen Specter. Here to talk about the results is poll director Dr. Terry Madonna. Are you surprised by the numbers we're seeing now?
Well, actually not. There were several polls that showed this drift towards Sestak for the past week or so, and, you know, a 2 percentage point lead for Joe Sestak, and guess what? The party shift, a lot of Democrats don't like that. Arlen Specter, April 28th of last year, changed parties to Sestak's, reminding the Democratic voters of all the votes Arlen Specter casts for Republican policies and programs. And three, there is very, very strong anti-incumbency in the electorate right now. Voters are looking at it and say, Washington, maybe we need some big change. Arlen Specter, five terms, running for a sixth, sort of a poster child for long-term incumbency, and some Democrats don't like that.
Let's take a look at the numbers. It's 38 to 36, and one more thing I want to bring up here is a recent campaign ad that's getting a lot of attention by Joe Sestak's campaign.
Yeah, that's right. Well, let me just explain this. They don't quite add up. We put these 15% undecideds, or when we add the leaners, you know, those voters who are leaning to either Sestak or Specter, and we end up with, you know, it'd be 25% if we didn't add the leaners. Add the leaners, you got 15%. The bigger point here is about 15% of the voters are undecided.
Right.
That's the big point.
In a close race, yeah.
Yeah, the ad, I think the most devastating ad I've ever seen is the ad with, you know, Joe Sestak runs. Now, remember, Democrats aren't exactly wild about President Bush or Sarah Palin.
Sure.
Then at the end, he has Arlen Specter saying, I changed parties to get, and notice the inflection, re-elected.
Right, you bet.
I mean,
it
for
is.
Democrats, that is a tough, tough ad.
All right, quickly, let's look at Specter going up, or I should say Pat Toomey going up against Specter and Sestak. We got two different numbers. First, we'll start with Toomey, Specter.
Yeah, I mean, here what's clear is that Specter and Toomey would run about even if the election were held today, but look at the huge number of undecideds. Then we have Sestak up if you look at Sestak against him, similarly, he would be competitive. Big point, both Democratic candidates would be in a competitive election. The election were held today against Pat Toomey.
Bottom line here, as we go to the primary, we just can't tell right now, Specter or Sestak.
It's too close to call. We could be up very late on May 18th in the evening. Who knows? But I'll tell you what, no one expected it to get quite this close.
Exactly.
Close, but not quite.
Yeah, what a race. All right, thank you very much, Terry.
Thanks.
We appreciate it.